Versen.
NANI?!
これは…
So, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. So, welcome back. Let's now go to the discussion proper of special crime investigation. Special crime. Now, dito is crime without crime scene. Wherein, it's hard to prove. It's very complex na hindi kasha ang parang yung soko lang na gamitin to prove a crime. Hindi siya, for example, hindi siya yung normal na crime na wherein rape, for example, may crimes din siya na if nakuha nila yung fingerprints, semen samples, eh, pwede mo nang masolve yung crime kasi malalaman mo na kung sino yung suspect, di ba? Dito sa special crime, it's either marami siyang crime scene to which mahirap siyang i-analyze, na mahirap siyang i-prove, for example. Or, hindi mo ma-determine kung ano talaga yung nangyari or ano talaga yung ginawa sa crime scene. For example, yung pag-create ng drug matrix. So, one special crime is proving that the drug lord may collusion ng politician sa drug lord. So, is special crime yan. Kasi, it's hard to prove kasi kailangan i-prove mo yung connection nila, kailangan i-prove mo yung ginagawa nilang masama. Marami kang dapat i-prove as an investigator to this, or money laundering. Maraming aspect ng money laundering na kailangan mong i-connect bago sabihing money laundering. So, for example, meron yung tinatawag nilang placement layering and integration. Placement is putting the dirty money, yung, for example, kinuha sa drug trade, tapos i-introduce mo yan sa economy. So, maraming process yan. So, kung kaya mong i-prove yan, edi, proving that one is the purpose of special crime investigation. So, hindi, sabi pa dito, it's different from sensational crime. Sensational crime is parang normal crime siya na parang pina-public. For example, sinensationalize ng media. For example, may isang prominent na individual, either politician or businessman na nag-commit ng crime at na-involve ang media. That is a sensational crime. It is actually a simple crime pero meron lang kasing media. So, that's not special crime. Basta, special crime is a complex one where it involves so much investigation efforts. So, one example of special crime is the organized crime. So, organized crime, actually, there's no proper definition for that. So, organized crime is any crime committed by a person occupying an established division of labor position designed for the commission of crimes, providing that such division of labor include at least one position for a computer, one position for a corruptee, and a position for an enforcer. So, in a nutshell, ito yung mga crime na ginagawa ng mga organized crime group. And ano yung mga organized crime group? So, for example, mafia in the US, wherein ito ay criminal organization. No, for example, nagbibigay sila ng service, parang service para makakita ng pera. For example, nagbebenta sila ng drugs, nag-gun for hire sila. So, that is organized crime. May parang organization sila. May organizational structure. So, yun. Actually, yung organized crime is organized crime group has no proper definition. It has no parang it's somewhat walang parang unifying definition for that. Meron lang mga definition ng for one place in the US. May definition din ng isang state sa US. Ganun. Parang wala pang unifying definition for organized crime group. Pero sabi ng United Nations is a structured of group of three or more persons existing for a period of time acting in concert with the aim of committing one or more serious crime or offense, establishing order to obtain direct or indirectly financial or material benefits. So sabi dito, structured groups, so meaning organization yan na may division of labor, for example, president, vice president, mga man nila, etc. of three or more persons. So as I have research sa organized crime group na subject namin noon is parang may similarity sila ng definition for organized crime groups, pero somewhat an organized crime group is parang it is very, it's a very formal structure na meron talagang boss, may underboss at may mga tauhan ganun. At different siya sa different siya sa gang, different din siya sa terrorist group. Sa gang kasi wala din actually proper definition kasi parang organized crime group 'yan. Pero gang is ito yung parang pinagmulan ng organized crime group. So for example, yung for example may isang gang, for example gang A na parang nagbebenta din ng drugs pero konti lang sila, mga bata ganun. Pero nung nagtra-transition na sila, parang lumalaki na siya. Yun yung parang nagiging organized crime group sila. So, yun yung parang rough definition natin dito is a group of or association of three or more who may have a common identifying sign, symbol, or name who individually collectively engage in or have engaged in criminal activity with which creates an atmosphere of fear, intimidation. Criminal activities includes juvenile acts that if committed by an adult would be a crime, can be hierarchical or not, can last long or short, can be structured or not, can transition into organized crime. So, pwedeng may hierarchy, may boss din, may underboss, at may mga tauhan. Pwede ding hindi. Parang, yung for example, motorcycle gang or yung mga gang-gang dyan sa inyo. For example, kung walang boss, wala kayong boss, yung sarili nyo lang, hindi siya hierarchical. Can last long or short. Meron yung gangs na it can reach to 20 years, 40 years, meron din yung hindi. Can be structured. Yung may parang system ng recruitment, kanan, may system ng activities, pero pwede ding hindi. So, somewhat, yung difference ng gangs and organized crime group is that gangs are, parang, it is the start of the organized crime group. And most likely, gangs are made up of mga bata. And most likely, gang can, parang, nabuo lang ang gang. They commit crime for psychological happiness or for example, for psychological gratification. So, yung para sa brotherhood lang ganun. Or for the sense of belongingness. Pero sa organized crime group, is mostly the purpose is to get profit. Pero gang can, yung purpose ng gang can be that also. So yun, that's all about gangs. Ano naman terrorism? Actually, there's no proper definition for it. Kasi nga, noon, hindi ko alam kung natag ng terrorist ang NPA. Yun nga, dahil walang proper definition for it, is somewhat nung hindi pa natag na terrorist group ang NPA, parang political party daw ang NPA na parang they are freedom fighters, which is very different from what they act. They act as if they were terrorists na pumapatay, nagpupuwerte gamit ng gobyerno, ganun. And those are terrorist act, pero dahil nga parang walang proper definition is that they were tag as freedom fighters. Pero I think natag na silang terrorist group. So, the United States sabi dito, premeditated political motivated violence perpetrated against non-combatant targets by subnational groups or clandestine usually intended to influence an audience. So, for example of terrorists are ISIS, Hezbollah, Abu Sayyaf group, NPA, lahat na yun. They target non-combatant, sabi dito. They target yung civilian, hindi yung military. And why do they target that? To send a message, to spread fear, to terrorize. So that's the purpose of it. And mostly, terrorism is either political in nature, very political in nature, na they want to change the government, or they are part of the opposition, or they can be used by the opposition. It's either yung purpose nila is ideological or religious. Meron mga din mga religious terrorists, especially in the Middle East. Meron din yung ideological. For example, NPA, na communism yung ideology nila. Alam niyo naman, di ba, yung difference ng ideology and religion. Ideology is somewhat, they do not, basta, tingnan niyo sa dictionary. So, back to the organized crime group. So, according to Abadinsky, these are the attributes of an organized crime group. Lack of political goals. Hindi sila yung terrorist. Ito yung differentiation nila sa terrorist group. They have no lack, they have no political goals. They don't intend to be involved in politics. Pero meron yung iba na nakiki-involve para lang makakuha ng pero. Pero yung goal talaga ng organized crime group is to get money. It's not to parang change the political landscape of an area. Hierarchical in structure. So may boss, may under boss, may mga tauhan, hierarchy. May parang level of authority sa organized crime group. Limited or exclusive membership. So napipili lang ang nakikisali sa organized crime group. So for example, sa mafia, dapat Italian ka, dapat miyembro ka ng family, or dapat relative ka dapat bago ka maging part ng isang mafia. For example, constitution as a unique subculture. So gumagawa sila ng sarili nilang mundo. Yun lang yung sabi dito. Self-perpetuation. So somewhat they last long. Na even though it parang may war sila sa government, they can, or for example, they can really last long. 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. That's the meaning of self-perpetuation. Willingness to use illegal violence and bribery. So they are willing to kill you. Sa service nga nila, they have gun for hire, they have guns, they have bombs. Bribery, they can, especially, ito yung parang medyo political side niya, pero hindi siya, hindi yung goal niya. Yung they bribe public official to, for example, to protect them. Demonstrate specialization of division of labor. So, different mafias have, parang, organized crime groups have different parang services. Meron yung gun for hire, meron yung mix na drugs, or meron silang mga, or sa organized crime group, meron silang mga professional parang criminals na one is siguro hacking, another part is selling drugs, another part is bribery. So parang sa unit ng police, meron silang drug unit, bribery unit, parang ganun. So they have specialized knowledge. Monopolism dito is an organized crime group hates other organized crime group, or if they share a territory, they can parang sometimes meron yung war na yun. Yun nga, sa US meron yung mafia war, no, na nag-away yung different families ng, kalimutan ko na yung pangalan, pero nag-away-away yung mga different mafias kasi they want to control yung market, no? For example, Mafia A wants to control the market of Area A, pero nakisawsaw yung Mafia B na they want to also to get the money from the people in Area A. So maglalaban yan. Meron din actually yung nagpa-partner, pero that's another story. Strict rules and regulation. Meron yung, for example, nito is they have the Omerta Code, na it is a vow of silence, na it is very much important kung magre-recruit sila or sa training nila na i-inculcate ang Omerta Code. Na kahit, for example, isang member ng mafia or organized crime group is nahuli ng police, hindi siya mag-i-squeal, or hindi niya sasabihin kung sino yung boss niya. That is, kahit anong gawin nila sa nahuling member ng organized crime group niya. Ayan. So, ano yung organizational structure ng organized crime group? Meron ng boss, of course, has the final word. Meron yung consigliere, a trusted advisor. So, advisor ng boss. Meron yung underboss na tauhan ng boss, pero may tauhan siya. Meron yung kapos, ito yung mid-level managers. Meron yung soldiers. So actually different yung organizational structure, depende yan sa organized crime group na pinag-uusapan natin actually, pero ito lang is yung common na nilagay ko. So how do organized crime group members work? So there's an enforcer, one who makes the arrangement for killings and injuring the members or non-members. Meron corrupter, one who bribes, buys, intimidation, threats, negotiates. Meron yung corruptee, meron yung, ayun. So, enforcer, ito yung tali mga soldier, or siguro yung, basta, member of the organized crime group. Yun yung gumagawa ng dirty work. Sila yung pumapatay, sila yung dumidisiplina sa kanilang member. Or, sila yung, parang, they are the enforcer of the rules and regulation of the organized crime group, or sila yung nag-initiate, or sila yung nagpro-practice ng lahat ng sinasabi ng boss or yung underboss. Yung corruptor naman, usually ito is smooth talker yan. Magaling yan makipag-communicate sa mga tao. Ito yung basta sila yung nag-bribe sa mga public official. Sila yung nag-offer ng pera. Ayan. Corrupti naman. Corrupti is yung, for example, yung na-bribe na public official na the protector of the organized crime. Usually police. Or basta politician yan. So, what are the sources of the dirty money? So, there are two types of sources. The distribution and sale of illicit goods and services. So, sometimes, one source of the money that the organized crime group profit from are the distribution of or the sale of drugs, the sale of women, or pinapagamit nila yung gambling, may gambling den sila, pornography, meron din yung loan sharking na nagpapautang at maraming malaking interest, extortion, or gun for hire. Meron din yung second form. Activities associated with organized crime group like use of violence or political corruption. Ito yung parang they partner with a certain politician so that the politician will pay the organized crime group. Yung parang nakikipartner sila sa yun nga, sa politician or other organized crime group. Yan, okay. So let's go to characteristics of organized crime. So it's a conspiracy activity involving coordination of members. Economic gain is achieved through illegal means. So, syempre, kaya nga, either, sabi dito is conspiracy activity. So meaning, pinag-isipan yan with at in-execute ng mga members ng organized crime group. Parang, as a group nilang ginawa ang activity. Economic gain is achieved through illegal means. So, yun nga, sale of drugs, sale of pali human trafficking, ano pa, arms trafficking, yung binibenta nila yung mga guns, bombs, or paraphernalias ng bombs, ano, etc. Economic gain is the primary goal. Ito yung differentiation nila sa terrorism. The goal is to get money. Employ predatory tactics such as intimidation, violence, and corruption. So, yes, predatory tactics means violence. Mostly violence yan. Or yun nga, intimidation, violence, and corruption. Effective control over members, associate, and victims. So, effective control means if you, as a member of the organized crime group, if you committed or if you did not follow the rules and regulation of the organized crime group where you belong, you will either be punished or be killed. So, that's how effective it is. Organized crime does not include terrorists dedicated to political change. Kaya nga kasi, terrorist or mga, terrorist has political parang change as their primary goal. So, organized crime group is, it's economic. So, what are the generic types of organized crime group? So, political graft, manned by political criminals who use force or violence of a means to obtain profit or achieving political aims. So, these are the partners of the politicians actually. For example, if yung organized crime group ko is nag-specialize ako sa in extortion or marami akong tao, kaya pwedeng parang irerent ng politician yung private army po. Army ko to bully yung mga tao yung gusto niyang i-bully in exchange for money. One type is political graft. So, basta, organized crime group, kung political graft na organized crime group is, usually, these are the partners of the politicians. Meron din yung mercenary, predatory, organized crime group. Crimes committed by groups for direct personal profit but they prey upon unwilling victims. For example, gun for hire na walang partner, etc. So, for example, may nag-order sa amin, pumunta sila sa prang page namin sa internet or nakikipag-communicate sila para patayin itong pang tao na to in exchange for money. So, after they give their money, we will kill the target. So, ganun. They prey upon unwilling victim. In-group oriented organized crime. Groups manned by semi-organized individuals whose major goals are for psychological gratification such as adolescence gang. So, siguro ito yung somewhat ito yung mga gang members. Yung parang these are organized crime group na nagmula sa mga na parang nagtra-transition pa into somewhat into a proper organized crime group na nagmula sa gang-gang na yan. So yung sabi dito is for psychological gratification, for brotherhood, for the sense of belongingness, for parang siguro for drug session, you know, it is parang ginagawa, parang na-form itong organized crime group na to for psychological gratification. Pwedeng, for example, yung mga motorcycle gang na they form those group para may sense of belongingness nila na parang they are part of a certain brotherhood that they will want to protect. Ganun. So, let's now go to the syndicated crime, which is the using of illicit activity through the use of force, threat, or intimidation. So, somewhat, ito yung parang general type ng organized crime group wherein which they use force, threat, and intimidation. So, for example, loan sharking, na ganun, na for example, nangutang ka sa organized crime group na yan, so, yung interest is, for example, pag hindi mo nabayaran yan, or per month, nag-increase ng 100% interest. So, may mga ganun. So, they will use force or threat they will use to you para mabayaran mo yung inutang mo, na loan mo. So, yun. Yung parang difference nila sa mercenary is parang direct na, sabi dito. Direct personal profit. Wherein, sa syndicated is parang, for example, sa loan sharking is parang hindi pa yan direct kasi nagpautang ka. Somewhat direct din, pero mas direct ang mercenary. Or, yun. So, let's now go to the essential composition of organized crime. So, one is professional crime. Sometimes the organized crime group, or most of the time, they commit professional crimes. So, professional crimes are those that committed by a person in a profession. For example, an accountant wherein he tries to edit or hide yung dirty money ng money laundering. Or sa police, kasi profession yan. PNP yung may bibigay niyang service is kinakailangan ng organized crime group, kaya kinokorap niya, eh that can be a professional crime kasi nga yun. So ano yung characteristic ng professional crime? Crime is a sole means of livelihood, careful planning, reliance upon technical skills, methods, siya lang yung makakagawa. Offenders are migratory lifestyle, the groups have shared sense of belongingness, rules, codes of behavior, and mutual specialized language. So professional crime, so sabi dito, is the sole means of livelihood. So for example is yung accountant ng organized crime group na ito lang yung kaya niyang gawin. So it's parang it's a way for him to survive in organized crime. So in parang editing yung mga documents para maging legal, it involves his skills as an accountant. Siya lang yung makakagawa yun kasi siya lang yung may alam sa accountancy. Offenders are migratory lifestyle, so magpapalit-palit sila ng parang they go from place to place and etc. Okay, so let's now go to white collar crime. So white collar crimes are crimes that is committed by the upper echelon of the society, yung mga doctors, lawyers, yung mga high profession. Those are white collar crimes. So what are the forms? So corporate crimes, so they're actually hidden sila. There exists yung mga organized crime group na nasa taas, na involve ang politician, involve ang business owners, and etc. So, they commit corporate crimes. So, sabi dito, violation of corporate statute. Example is tax evasion. So this organized crime group composed of businessmen, for example, or mga, ano pa ba? Attorneys, ano pa? Colluded with mga businessmen, attorneys, ano pa, accountants, mga member ng parang tax law enforcer or BIR, ganun. Yes, they try to parang lokohin yung government para hindi sila magbayad ng tax, maubusan yung tax, may parang palitan yung parang assets nila para para magbayad lang sila ng konting tax, ganun. So, usually, ito yung ginagawa ng mga organized crime group in yung in the corporate world. So siguro I think is meron ganun dito sa Philippines dahil na-involve ang, for example, ABS, ganun, na tignan mo nga naman na ang liit ng binabayaran nilang tax wherein siguro may collusion pero may, yun nga yung dito is special crime ito kasi it's so hard to prove it na may collusion ng ano yung collusion ng iba't ibang mga tao ng mga member ng organized crime na ito. Tsaka yun, nagsettle actually ng government ng magbayad na lang yung ABS ng pera or yung isa yung percentage ng tax nila nang hindi nila binayaran. Basta na, tingnan niyo sa news yung ganun. Meron din yung airport ata. Airport ba yun yung hindi nagbayad ng tax? Rin siguradong nag-collude ang head ng BIR dyan at yung business owner ng airport ata yun or isang company. I don't know. Basta if corporate crime ang tinatawag is basta business-related na law ang kanilang parang vinviolate. Environmental crimes naman. Damage some protected or otherwise significant aspect of the natural environment. May mga organized crime group wherein sila is may sarili silang bangka or parang malaking boat ship. Tapos yung or collusion din ng mga official ng customs. Tapos isang business owner din dun sa, for example, sa Japan, na yung basura, for example, ng Japan, pinupunta sa Pilipinas, pero nakalagay on paper as parang mga goods, na legal goods, pero yun pala basura. So yun yung nangyari noon, di ba? Basura sa Canada, sa Korea. Tali, kagagawa niya ng, di ba, walang nagkasala dun. Parang hindi nila ma-determine kung sino. Yung mga personnel lang ng custom yung may parang nakita nilang parang parang kinasuhan nila, I think. Another is occupation crimes. Any act punishable by law which is committed through opportunity created in the course of an occupation that is legal. So, for example, the doctors, yung siguro doctors ba? Basta yung mga crimes na kinakomit ng doctors, lawyers, na in the performance of their duty. So, siguro sa doctors is yung pag ano kaya? Negligence, ganun. Or sa lawyer naman is pamemeke. Or ayun. Basta crimes that they commit in the practice of their profession to serve the organized crime group. So, what are the categories of organized crime behavior? Five levels of organization. The criminal group. The criminal group represents the criminal core of organized crime. So, the criminal group is composed of usually yung center dun is yung boss, yung consigliere at yung mga underboss. Protectors naman. So, include public official, business people, judges, attorneys, yung mga yung hindi yung parang nare yung kinurap nila na public official na they will serve as the protector sa government. For example, mga police, mga politician, etc. Specialized support includes person who provide contract service that facilitate organized crime activities such as pilots, chemists, arsonists. Sometimes organized crime group employs yung mga ganito. Chemists para mailuto nila yung kanilang shabu, mga different types of drugs, ganun, etc. User support provides criminal group with their consumer market. Person who purchase organized crime goods, illegal goods and services such as drug users, patrons, pawnmakers. So, user support is ito yung suki ng organized crime group. So, if yung organized crime group is nagbebenta ng drugs, sila yung bumibili. Social support involves persons in organization who create a perception of legitimacy for organized crime. So, actually, parang protector sila. Pero sa mat oh, protector sila. Tulad ng mga politician who solicit supports business group who partners with the OCGN, etc. So, hindi lang actually protectors, pero they can be the media wherein they tell people that the or parang for example there exists an organized crime group in the area. Pero yung social support is parang sinasabi nilang wala. They try to hide yung existence ng organized group na yan. Yun. So let's go to the models of organized crime. So noon, nung actually this is parang from the birth to naging adult ang organized crime, yung definition ng organized crime group or organized crime, meron yung alien conspiracy theory. OCGR from other countries, especially Italy. So, dito sa theory na to is kasi usually yung mga yung first na organized crime group is yung mga migrants or immigrants galing sa Italy. Di ba nakikita niya naman sa movies is mostly dinedepict nilang mga drug lord dyan is yung mga Italian, di ba? Italian sa New York, etc. Or European countries. According naman kay Crazy sa Cosa Nostra model niya is organized crime model as rigid bureaucratic structure that primary unit of the Cosa Nostra is family that embodied by male ancestry. Where the code hierarchical. So, as they study yung mga organized crime group or yung mafia sa US, is they found out that actually, the La Cosa Nostra is a mafia or an organized crime group. Ito yung parang subject of the study nila is that they, sa mafia na ito, is they see that yung mga members, lahat ng members ng mafia na yun is nanggaling sa isang family tree na if you're outside the family tree, then you can never be a member. Except on special cases. So, yung parang nagpaparami ng syempre yung authority, yung mas maraming power ang gender na male or mostly yung mga babae lang nila is for parang accessory lang na wala lang parang for sex or anything ganun. Meron din silang umerta code wherein the vow of silence na they will not tell anything, they will not tell or squeal anything from the organized crime. May hierarchical, may boss, may underboss, may capo, may consigliere, etc. So yun yung parang nakita ni Crazy sa La Cosa Nostra. So Albini patron client model, Joe Albini and Francis Zelan. Sorry, parang re-define nila yung organized crime group. Sabi niya, yung Cosa Nostra pala, as a web of asymmetric ties embedded in local ethnic network, consists of a series of patron client relationship. Those with the most power can provide the most service, characterized by conflict. So as time goes by, mas maraming information na nadadagdag sa definition ng organized crime group. So yung nakita ni Albini at ni Lani is that in a mafia, parang there are other mafia, there are other organized crime group that competes with each other, wherein an organized crime group hindi naman very strict sa membership or hindi siya strict sa pagiging parang minsan hindi sila monopolistic, parang nagiging nakikipartner na sila sa ibang mafia or in if one mafia needs another mafia or one organized crime group needs another organized crime group is they form a partnership or tinatawag nilang patron client relationship. But mostly though is if may in the parang opposite end na if may nangyari na masama in sa partnership is they will make war with each other. An OCG will battle with another OCG. So then hindi yung sa definition ng Albin and Lani is that most of the time is it doesn't really hindi sila strict sa membership or sa partnership with other outside their ethnic ties or outside their family. Kasi as long as you provide the service, if you give money, ganun is pwede kang maki-join. Or if you give, for example, may family ako na dapat yung family member ko lang yung i-employ ko as members of my organized crime group. Pero meron akong kulang ako ng attorney ganun or kulang ako ng accountant, edi mag-employ na lang ako, parang I will ask someone to be a member na outside my family ganun. Okay, so punta tayo sa Smith's Enterprise model. So dito na yung parang parang talagang nag-give away na sila or naging parang re-inject na nila yung Cosa Nostra model and yung alien conspiracy theory. Wherein, sinasabi na is organized crime group is basta any organization that does parang illegal business or they do it as a group. For example, nag-provide sila ng drug, nag-distribute sila ng drug, drugs or mga firearms or loan sharking, edi matatawag mo na yung na-organized crime group. Kasi kahit hindi sila yung parang mafia na talagang dapat yung members is kablad mo. Kasi yun yung kay crazy. Pero dito is basta if they commit this as a group, then they are considered an organized crime group. So punta tayo sa Haller's partnership model. So in-expand niya yung sinasabi ni Smith na as long as you colluded with someone, for example, there is an organized crime group and a business owner wanted, parang for example, wanted to kill his competitor, so he employed yung services ng organized crime group na to para patayin yung business, yung gusto niyang ipapatay na nakikikompete sa kanya, is yun, parang ganun ang organized crime group. Hindi lang yung organization mismo ng organized crime group, nakikipartner din sila sa normal na tao, lalo na sa mga politician or mga business part organization. So pag iisipin mo yan, is siguro may organized crime group dito sa Pilipinas, hindi mo lang pansin. Siguro masasabi natin ang Liberal Party ay organized crime group dahil nakikolude sila sa media. Tingnan mo nga, parang sa dilawan na yung ABS, di ba? Yung, for example, hindi sila nagbayad ng taxes nila, or basta, if you connect yung mga ganun sa Liberal Party, yung mga supporters ng Liberal Party, you can actually be convinced na they are one organized crime group. Pero sa akin lang yun. So, ano to? Ah, shit. So, punta tayo sa last part. Meron dito sa mga type din ng mga organized crime. Meron yung small scale, may traditional, meron yung non-traditional organized crime group. So, small scale, not affiliated with traditional organized crime families of the historical variety, but remain as organized criminal group. So, siguro ito yung mga, for example, mga gangs, or yung mga medyo malilit pa na organized crime group na hindi siya mafia. So, for example, siguro yung mga for example, ano kayang example dito? Kasi pag if we talk about traditional organized crime, is yun yung mga mafias na nanggaling sa Italy, sa siguro sa, yung ito yung mga traditional organized crime group na sila yung reason kung bakit na ini-study natin yung organized crime group, na sila yung parang origin. Oh, sila yung point of reference nila noon kung ano yung organized crime group. Yung non-traditional naman is ito yung dumagdag lang sa traditional na magkaiba, na hindi sila, hindi na kailangan Italian, hindi na kailangan kadugo mo yung organized crime group members na ganun. So, okay, so let's read the definitions. Traditional is related to historical processes and linkages that reflect early immigration into the US. Yun nga, from Italy. So, pag Italy, from Italy, that is traditional organized crime, or from other countries, or yung basta from Italy, from European country. Yung non-traditional naman, reflected in a new shifts and movements within the criminal elements that do not fit the traditional organized crime framework. Yung to yung mga non-Italian, or hindi nila pinapractice yung traditional organized crime culture, tulad ng yun nga, yung hindi kailang kadugo mo, ganun. So one example is yung mga triad from the Asian countries. So yung may actually triad dito, may nag-migrate yung mga triad sa different parts of the world na hindi na kailangan kadugo mo, basta if you can provide a service and you want money, then you can be a member of that organized crime group. Yung sa small scale is basta, sa small scale na yun, is basta they are a little, they are very late. Parang hindi pa nila kayang makipag hindi pa nila kayang maki hindi na nila kayang mak putang. So sa small scale, so from the word small scale is they are somewhat small, small, maliit pa, na hindi sila galing sa Italy, na parang nagmula sila sa parang bigla silang nagform sa isang area na maliit pa lang, hindi pa sila, hindi pa nila kayang mag-migrate sa ibang bansa, tulad ng sa triad. Actually, sa triad is nag-migrate sila sa ibang bansa, hindi pa nila kaya yung ganun. Parang small scale lang nila yung parang isang area lang yung kaya nilang i-service ng organized crimes. Yun. So sa triad sa is international yan actually. So from China to US or to other countries. Ayun. So yun lang. I hope you understand. Thank you.